against Americans. And the 5 out of 51 of House representatives, they endorsed for supporting Hawaii home grown Filipino terrorists against the Americans. So total together, 15 out of 76 Hawaii lawmakers who endorsed for supporting Hawaii homegrown Filipino terrorists against Americans.
Okay, wait, you're repeating yourself. So let me ask you some questions so we can straighten this out. You say that 15 lawmakers endorsed supporting Filipino terrorists. Mm-hmm. What action was taken?
They have signed their name and provide their address. And
what did they sign exactly?
Sign. There is a document. You know, they circle.
It's not a statute, though. They didn't pass a bill or anything. They just signed a resolution letter.
Signed, they signed for endorsement. There's that Filipino terrorists. They generate a.
Why would they do such a thing?
Against my lawsuit settlement.
Yeah.
The secondly, they supporting Hawaii homegrown Filipino terrorists.
Yeah, okay, but you're repeating yourself. Why do you want them indicted? Who do you want indicted? You want lawmakers to be indicted?
Yes, because it is.
What's the crime? Isn't there a First Amendment?
Guilty.
Or guilty of saying something?
Name away. This sign their name.
Isn't that a free amendment, a First Amendment free speech issue?
For endorsers,
are you saying that they cannot make a statement about their feelings?
It is wrong because they, Hawaii homegrown Filipino terrorists, they are terrorists.
And let me ask, why do you say by March 25th? Why is that date important?
My dear fiancé and my attorney, Byron Wessel, must indict them by March 25th.
Why is that date important?
3 weeks.
Why is that date important?
Because they must resign. I gave them 3 weeks to resign.
Okay. All right. Well, that's your deadline then.
Yes. Do you know who are those 10 senators? They including Donna Kim and Henry Aquino. And I have a list.
So you have a beef with a lot of senators. Have you written to them? Have you talked to them?
I sent that email to some senators. And
okay, what did they do in response?
They did not respond to me.
Okay. All right. I think we're going to go now. I think we got the message. Thank you very much, madam. Do you represent an organization or are you just by yourself?
Firstly, I am a leader of fighting against Hawaii homegrown Filipino terrorists.
Okay, do you represent an organization?
I represent myself and represent Justice Society.
Okay, Justice, there you have it. Okay, we find the most interesting people here at Bishop Square, Tamarind Park. We're going to keep on walking and finding people and enjoying what has to say. in fact, there's Bill. Bill, wait a minute, Bill. Bill, oh, yeah. Okay, Bill.
Excuse me.
Next time, Bill. That's Bill Brennan. He's an old friend. All right, we're going to continue. Thank you very much, madam. Yeah. Okay. Exciting. All right. Larry. I love your daughter, by the way. Can you talk to me for a minute? Give me your thoughts about the national political scene.
Oh, I'd prefer not to.
Okay, well, how about the local political scene?
What about it?
Whatever your thoughts are.
You know, I'd rather go off the record.
Okay,
right?
We'll talk later. Let me ask you about the economy. How do you feel the economy is doing?
I think the economy seems to be doing better than the rest of the country. I think that the momentum of tourism has continued to spur growth, and also the construction industry, at least for another year, will probably be another basis for continued growth.
You know, there was a don't know if you saw it, but there was a report by UHERO, the UH Economic Research Organization, and they said that they suspected there was a slight decline of degradation.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure. I didn't read it, so I don't know exactly why.
Right.
But, did you see it? Do you have any thoughts about that?
I didn't read the report, but based on news summaries about their report, seems to me that, of course, they're experts, so they would have a better idea or estimate of what the economy looks like going forward. But, you know, this concern about 2018 when construction is supposed to really drop all of a sudden, I think that factored in. I think that tourism will continue to remain strong, especially as other countries seem to have problems with security, and you know, this, a lot of tourists go to Mexico, but there should be still many would be coming to Hawaii. So, and Japan still feels safe here in Japanese there. So I think that should keep it going.
Well, you know, one thing is, you know, we've heard recently about the Chinese coming and buying large trophy properties, properties with tremendous implications. But we haven't seen them very much. It's sort of under the radar somehow. Have you had contact? Do you have any, have you met with them, or do you have any personal knowledge of how they're doing?
All secondhand from other lawyers in our firm. There is that potential because they have such great wealth, especially individually or through companies, and you know, it's constant balance of payments and balance of trade against the U.S. that, you know, they're building up their, I'm sure they're building up their, you know, their assets such that they have to invest it. And I don't think there's as much of opportunity in China as there is in the U.S. So, and it balances things out. With their favorable balance of trade and balance of payments, that they would want to invest in the United States for diversification of their
industry. Very important to us, as the Japanese are, and we have to retain our connections with them, don't you think, to continue the economy as a connected with the global economy?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I'm not sure. The Trump factor is so much of concern to everybody, and how that plays out will be an important factor in which direction that goes, but also the attitude, you know, the Chinese in the long run will be a strong factor in what happens as a result of whatever our government does.
Yeah, well, thank you, Larry.
Okay, Jay.
Okay, we'll be here next time. We'll find you again.
Where is this for? I'm doing this out of...
This is actually live back to our studio.
Is that right?
And we're broadcasting it on the internet.
Is that...
So, well, if you're not already as famous as you want to be, now you'll be even more famous.
Well, I've known Jay. Well, you don't have to continue this. But Jay has a lot of credibility.
We're in the middle of a half an hour of bots. So. Thank you for helping us fill the time, Larry.
Okay, I'm glad to be of help to you.
Take care. Okay, that was really interesting. He's a partner at the Carl Smith firm, and they have seen it all over the past, since statehood. It's a huge firm, one of the biggest and best in town. And it's been a firm that has seen the development of the state since statehood, even before statehood. And you could write the history books on the matters that Carl Smith has handled. A couple of decades ago, they merged with a San Diego firm, the Ball firm, as it were. Now it's called Carl Smith Ball. But it and that made it even more influential and gave it, you know, greater contacts on the mainland. So here we are. We're walking up toward the district court building at Hotel Street. Seems quiet here. I wish there were more people around, but we'll keep on asking. Sir, can we talk to you? Okay, can we talk to you, madam? We're nice people. We just want to ask you how you think the economy in Hawaii is doing. Can we ask you that? How do you think the economy in Hawaii is doing?
Japan.
Well, you're from Japan.
Yeah.
Oh, you're a visitor.
No, Sightseeing.
Okay. Well, do you like Hawaii? Do you like Hawaii?
Hawaii?
Yes, Hawaii.
Paradise.
Okay. All right.
Thank you.
Nice to see you here. Exciting. Well, you know, it's so interesting to see all these people and restaurants and businesses. But here we are. Let me remind you, it's a Tuesday, and that's a business day at, what is it? Just after 2 o'clock in the afternoon on a Tuesday, and it's not as crowded as you would have hoped. So I don't see traffic jams here. I see them in many other places on the island, but on a Tuesday in Bishop Square, Bishop Street, doesn't seem that crowded. What does this mean? Does this mean everybody's out somewhere else? Does it mean that everybody's busy behind his desk or her desk in the office buildings? Does it mean, you know, perhaps one of the elements of the UHERO report, could our economy be slowing down? Because after all, you know, this is the metric right here. This is where, you know, the professionals live. These are the people who enable, facilitate business deals, transactions, acquisitions, investments. They are right here, I thought. So we're going to go down, we're going to cross Bishop Street now, and we're going to look at what's going on at 4th Street Mall, which is only a short half block away. But if you take a shot of Bishop Street now at 3 o'clock on a Tuesday, you will see there's no traffic at all. Where'd everybody go? Are we losing it? Gentlemen, can I talk to you and ask you what you think of the economy?
What do we think of the economy?
What do you think of the economy?
Well, when I look along Ala Moana Boulevard, it tells me the economy is doing great. And I hope someday I can afford one of those apartments.
Can you give me a chance to talk? Is that local economy or national economy?
Well, I'll ask you about the national in a minute.
Oh, the local economy. I think it's a good economy. Yeah. It's yes. The apartments are a bit expensive, though.
Yeah. Well, let me tell you, there's an apartment up there that was listed for $100 million.
Oh, that's a lot.
And it sold at $95.
Well, that's more than I make in 6 months.
I'd like to spend more time with you. Maybe you could take me out for a nice meal at Morton's. Yeah. Yes. Anyway, so let's go to the national economy.
Sure.
You know, President Trump is in office now for several weeks.
Yes.
And he's taken some steps. He's very active, actually, this week.
Yes, yes.
I'm not sure everybody agrees with what he's doing, but he's been very active. The question I put to you is, how do you think that's going to affect the economy of these United States?
I think positive, in a positive way.
Positive.
That's my opinion, though.
You know, there are those who say the market has had a blush over his election ever since... you know, the inauguration, or even before the inauguration. Is that blush going to continue?
Probably, yeah. Might well, yeah. He's a businessman. Yeah. So I think he's taken from a business perspective. For me, that spells good for the economy. If you treat it as a business, then it's good, right?
Yeah, well, a case can be made that the government doesn't know how to do business, and only business guys know how to do business, and business is by definition more efficient because it has to stay alive. What do you think about this?
Well, if we look at the results, since the election in November, what has the stock market done?
Oh, it's been good.
It's been fantastic.
Do you think it'll continue?
Well, the stock market looks ahead, so it's seen... What we've seen is anticipation of good performance ahead. There are some good reasons to back it up. If he deregulates some of the things that have been heavily regulated, that's good for the economy. In many cases, that's good for the economy. It may not be good for everybody, but in general, deregulation can cost companies less money and make things happen faster.
You think the administration will shine down on Hawaii? I mean, for example, we voted against him. We're a Democratic state. We don't have a lot of Republicans around, present company excluded. He may not like us, and maybe he doesn't want to do much for us. On the other hand, where I'm confused about this, he wants to spend $52 billion more on defense. So my question to you both is, how will Hawaii fare in the new administration? Will we see the benefits of the Trump, the Trump new economy or not?
I think if the economy improves, it's going to improve for everybody. If the economy gets better, it's better for everyone, nationally speaking, Hawaii and every other states. So I think it will spill over to Hawaii. That's my opinion. But Yeah, if it's a, you know, if the economy is doing good, it's going to be doing good everywhere, including Hawaii.
What about globally? You know, will what's happening affect the global economy? Will that be positive or not?
No, I don't know. For some countries, it might not be as positive. Maybe like China or even Europe or even Canada for that matter. But for the state, it's good. Yeah. For the state, it'll be good, yeah.
Okay, well, you know, $52 billion, $54 billion, it can find a way to Pearl Harbor somehow in the shipyard there. What are your thoughts on this?
Oh, I'd love for the defense spending to help Pearl Harbor and Hawaii. All of these changes helping Hawaii. I think if you're a big investor in foreign oil, you may have some problems with the future. I think Trump would like to see us reduce our dependence on foreign oil. And so we may see more energy spending here in the U.S. and Canada, you know, the Balkan Shale and some of the other more local sources of oil. I'm all for that. You know, when I was a kid, the United States had the tallest building in the world and the best infrastructure. Where is that now? Now it's in Dubai. Why is it in Dubai? Because we've been buying so much of their oil, they use their money to make them number one in infrastructure. Trump promises to improve our infrastructure. I'd like to see that. I don't want Dubai to be number one. I'd like to see the U.S. be number one.
Wouldn't it be something if we got all patriotic again? You know, I've been thinking about that. We were very patriotic a few years ago. I was anyway. And now the sort of the jury's out on what's going to happen here and worry about it. Everybody worries about it. Do you think there's a room for patriotism now?
It depends how you define patriotism. How do you define patriotism? Like, what do you define it as? Like, everyone is patriotic in their own way. I mean, patriotic means you love your country, right?
Yeah.
And if you define it like this, then everyone is patriotic. Everyone who cares about this country is patriotic, right?
That's true.
In another sense, patriotism is to say that the government belongs to us, it is us, and we are the government. We are, you know, a unity. We are all the same in the government and in the country. After a very difficult campaign, you know, a lot of controversy and disparities and all that, can we come together again? What does it take?
Well, we can come together again. I think people have to believe that we'll work together as one, and maybe the people that are anti-Trump will take a look at their 401k statement and suddenly discover that, gosh, this is working out quite well. Perhaps Trump is a good thing. You know, there's a lot of things that make life good or bad, and everybody has different priorities. But a lot of people voted for Trump. So, you know, now that he's in office, let's give him a chance and see if we get the results that we need.
How much time do you give him?
Well, I think he's got 4 years. And if things go well, he gets another four. And then it's over, no matter what.
Would you give him full 4 years of honeymoon?
I don't know about honeymoon, but I'll give him the full 4 years, and after that, the people will decide whether they want to keep him or get rid of him. I mean, it's a people's government. It is a people's government, because at the end of the day, the people will decide who to choose for president, and that's what's been happening for centuries now.
Okay, let's continue that thought.
Yes.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank
great
you,
to
man.
Talk to you.
Very good.
Wonderful. Thank you for sharing, sir.
Thank you.
Aloha.
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 Bye.
Great to meet people like that. Hey, so we see all kinds of people on the street. They're willing to share with us. We are so happy to have that benefit. You know, I don't know if other places you could find the same kind of willingness to share, but in Hawaii, we always find somebody who's willing to tell us how they think. Maybe not immediately. Some people are shy. Some people, you know, they walk away. They say, I'm busy. Got an important meeting, whatnot, you know. Hear that a lot. But you always find people who will say something, who will share with you. And it comes from the art because it's strangers. You know, strangers tend to tell you what they're thinking. It's kind of anonymous what they say. It's like on the internet, you can make anonymous statements, and it enables you, it liberates you to be able to talk anonymously. Okay, we're heading now to 4th Street Mall. There are all the bus stops here in front of Long's and Ross's, and again, it seems quiet. You know, I have to say, those two guys we just spoke to seem to be the only two business guys that we saw in quite a while. And I'm not sure they were from Hawaii either. But that doesn't matter. They were willing to talk to us and share. So we're passing Long's Drugstore. McDonald's, Ross's, the buses, not crowded. Where did everybody go? Maybe everybody went on a vacation somewhere. Maybe they're all skiing in Aspen. What do you think? Anyway, we're going to walk further. Maybe we'll find some students. The problem is that the students are not here right now. HPU usually populates all of 4th Street with students. They walk all the way down from the, you know, the buildings, the HPU buildings at the top of 4th Street, all the way to Aloha Tower. And as a result, you know, they're all over the place. Let me see if this young man, will you talk to us about your thoughts?
About what?
About your thoughts about the economy. Will you tell us how you feel?
Okay.
How do you feel about the economy?
I think it's looking better, and I think people are more optimistic.
All right. Why?
I think with the elections, people are hopeful. Perhaps taxes will come down, regulations will get better, and, you know, change is good.
Yeah, change is good. And it helps us explore things maybe we didn't think about before. But what about the international aspect? You know, some people say that this administration is tearing up a lot of relationships. Does that have an effect? Where do you build that into your look at the future?
You know, the U.S. is always going to be a global player. The degree of which that we move forward into engaging more international relationships versus...
Okay, well, we have another voice. Thank you very much, sir. But let's resume where we were.
I'll try that over again. So I think that we're going to move in and out between more engagement international or pulling back, depending on whether it's guns and butter and who's in power. But I think that nobody's arguing with the fact that the president said he's going to try and take care of our country better. I think it'll be a more normal relationship than maybe the campaign rhetoric.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like his style. First you shake everything up, and then after a while you settle down. You feel about the same way or what?
Yeah, I think so. I don't think that Obamacare changing is going to be radical. I think it'll be moderate. I think it's going to take time before we can adjust what the taxes are going to be. I don't think it'll be severe cuts, but I think there'll be some sort of adjustment. And, yeah, I think the whole thing's going to moderate a lot more than, say, the sort of hyper-partisan feelings at the moment.
Yeah, that's not good for anyone, actually. It's time to come together, don't you think?
You know, I hope that will be the case. I think the country's wanted that for almost 10 years. You know, maybe they can all of us settle down a little more.
Yeah. That's so optimistic in the face of so much pessimism. From your lips to God's ears, sir.
You know, I hope so. But I'm an optimistic individual by nature. My glass is always half full.
All right. Thanks very much for sharing that with us.
You're very welcome.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Okay, that was nice. What's interesting is that he basically agreed with the other two guys that we just spoke with. So we're running into... you know, a lot of pro-administration feeling around here and optimism about the economy. I wonder if that's widely held. Not clear to me that it is, because a lot of the people I know don't feel the same way at all. And, you know, well, it's interesting how you take a wide survey in a downtown. You may have a tilt on it one way or the other. So we can't say that that's an accurate statement of how everyone feels. It's just ad hoc. It's just... some samples. And now we're going toward the 4th Street Mall, and we'll take a look both up and down and see what's here. We'll see who's here, see what's going on, and see if we can make sense of how it works on a Tuesday at 3 o'clock in a given early week in March. And where is 4th Street and Bishop Street and Honolulu going these days, at least according to this area here? So let's look up the street first. And what do we see? Not much of a crowd. Looks like it's a spring break for HPU. Not that much activity. Restaurants are open, shops are open, but it's not crowded. Okay, now we're looking. Oh, madam, can you talk to us for a moment?
It depends on what. You may not want my opinion.
Oh, no, I do want your opinion, whatever it is. We're First Amendment all the way. Is there any issue burning on your head these days?
Where is this going to be broadcast?
This is for ThinkTech Hawaii. We're a First Amendment green screen digital media company downtown a block away.
Right. Yeah. All right. No, I'm not who you think I am. I may be the opposite of what you're
saying. It's okay, whatever it is, it's all right.
Okay. So what's burning on my mind is the issue with the immigrants. Okay. I think it's very unfair, but I also think it's unfair to expect to bring 8,000 immigrants from Australia who have no jobs. We are going to have to put them on welfare, support them, feed them, clothe them, while we cannot take care of our own people. We have people sleeping in the streets. America first. And I am not a Republican, and I'm not for Trump, but that's one issue that I feel strongly about. When we did have all the immigrants came to America, there were jobs for them. We needed them in our factories and our farms, and they went right to work. They didn't go on welfare. So that's what I'm opposed to. Sorry.
Yeah, okay. Well, are you optimistic about this administration, or do you worry about it?
I'm worried to death about it, aren't we all?
What concerns you?
Associations with other countries. Sometimes you just have to play the game properly and be civilized, and I don't think that's happening right now. And if we tick off the wrong people, it could be very dangerous, I think. So yeah, that bothers me.
Well, I mean, every day there's something more about nuclear weapons and, missile race and nuclear race. The thing about nuclear races is that it makes it easier to push the button by accident. You worry about that?
Absolutely. I've been worried about it for forever, for 50 years at least, but now more than ever because it's all heated and we're not communicating. You know, anything that we do affects everybody else. It's a global issue, and we need to get together and not make enemies.
Let's leave it there. I really appreciate you talking to me. You're an elegant lady, and I appreciate all the moments we've had with you.
It was nice to meet you. Bye-bye.
Okay, well, that's interesting. So I think we got a batting average of 1,000% in favor of optimism. On the other hand, that woman was balanced in the sense that she was worried about what the administration would do on an international level. So, you know, one thing is clear is that these days the news is important. People are perhaps thinking more about it. These days there's passion. And maybe it's being even more refined now in these times of commotion and controversy. It seems like people are thinking more about it, and you don't know where they're going to come out. And it's good if they have their own views, and their views are perhaps different than they were before.